But what is your fondest memory from the beginning days with Punit?
I don't call it fondest, yeah, but most memorable.
Yeah.
When we met Nonini.
Okay.
Me and Frasha actually were dancers, like proper dancers.
Please just get out of here. Stop right there.
And it's
Stop.
Not just any songs. We were good at Lingala.
You guys used to compete.
Yes.
You guys were
used to
compete.
Yes, we used to compete. We used to compete. Any disco dancing competition, do you go Kitengela, iko Tao, tuko hapo, tushapiga routine, tuko sawa.
What is the group called?
Tuko to Beef. Boneye and Frasha.
Okay.
Beef.
It's funny, eh?
Yes.
So, so it happened, yeah, one of those days, kuliko na kulikuwa to Zip.
I remember Zip, yes.
So Nonini and Juakali used to hang out there a lot.
Yeah.
So as we used to go there, we had started recording some music here and there.
Yeah.
It wasn't working. So we were dancing out of our, you know, crazy, like crazy. And,
yeah,
and to make sure Nonini notices us.
Yeah.
So Nonini noticed us.
Okay.
And he's like, who are those two guys?
Yeah.
Bring them over. So we went, Nini, and we started off as Nonini's dancers.
Okay.
We used to go for gigs and we'd be there dancing to Totonzuri Kwangu, Asiwe Ma.
And you guys are...
And then, funny enough, I'm one of Nonini's biggest fans actually.
Yeah.
So I'd crammed all his songs.
Yeah.
So he noticed that as well.
Yeah.
So he started taking me for tours as his backup vocalist.
Ah, okay.
So you grew up, so you graduated from a dancer?
From a dancer to a backup
vocalist.
DVG.
Who can dance?
Who can dance?
Yes, yeah. Kaza Lingala.
We have clips. There are clips somewhere. Don't go searching on YouTube.
Oh Lord, I must. Okay, so then, and then what happened after you're touring with him? You're his backup.
Yeah,
dancer,
yeah, yeah. And then
singer.
The singer, and we recorded our first song.
Mm-hmm.
So we had these songs and we had an idea. So we sang for him the chorus for Sida Zima to do.
Oh, okay.
Me and Frasha.
Yeah.
And it was like, wow, these are better songs than all these crappy songs you've made me listen to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's go to the studio. So he took us to Ketabul,
mm-hmm,
and we found a producer called Jesse.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, Silazima became
the biggest,
huge.
Yes.
Like it became bigger than ourselves.
Yeah.
So tulikuwa wale vijana wa Nonini.
Mm.
So apo follow up, Nonini introduced us to Eric Msioka,
mm-hmm,
and we did Kushoto Kulia.
Yeah.
It was a huge song as well. But what happened is, Nonini was always the bigger artist.
Yeah.
So P-Unit walikuwa wale vijana wa Nonini.
Yeah.
So siya tunge ito show.
In the shadow.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Nonini walikuwa na ito show.
And then you go with.
Alafsa anatumia
ba.
So nakumuka siku moja, yenye ilifanya nione, we need to do something about this. Is because Nonini flew all the way to Dar es Salaam.
Yeah.
Na siya tulikuwa kwa basi na ina hosti kurusha rushwa hivi.
Going to the same gig.
Yeah. So, and after that gig, we had another gig in Kampala.
You were back on the bus.
Habo has flown back to Nairobi.
Yeah.
As you're on the bus, but there's no shukaing that you go home.
Yeah.
No. Apo apo kwa basi, change basi, ingia hii tuende Kampala.
Yeah.
I mean, nishukia kangemi. Yeah. I got off the bus and told Frasha and Gabu, adios.
It's been real.
It's been real.
Yeah.
And then, but so then, that's why I'm like, how do we come out of that shadow?
Mm-hmm.
How do we come out of that shadow?
Yeah.
And that's when I met DNA,
yeah,
had a huge song called Banjuka.
Mm-hmm.
So I met him at Madi, nini.
Yeah.
So there's this thing I used to tell the bouncers, we una nini, una kitu.
Yeah.
Una nini, una kitu. So we took that idea that night to Jomino.
Ah, yes. Wow.
And now we stopped being just Nonini's whatever, but became.
You are now Punit.
Punit, because we featured a new artist.
Mm-hmm.
And the rest is history.
What? I didn't know you guys were Lingala dancers. Sorry. That's what I've taken from all of that. Do send in your questions, please. The hashtag